Hello everyone. Now we are going to discuss on the Indus substation. So this is showing you just a single line diagram of an Indus substation which is a floor mounted. And Indus substations are being installed in industrial areas where the load requirements are very heavy and continuity of supply is very important. So in the case of industrial units, safety is also a concern, and also in the public places we may be going into the Indoor substation. So inside the substation room, there should have enough space in order to keep your transformer and its associated parts, incoming cable, outgoing cables, then the bus bars, then the control circuitry, measurement units, everything. So it should be spacious in nature, and all the equipment, there's adequate clearance between the equipment is also a major criteria to ensure the safety of the personnel. And this is a typical layout of the indoor substation. So here you can see that you are receiving your 11 kV supply from the transmission lines, which is, or distribution lines, which is going beside the industry or where you are going to keep your indoor substation. And first you will be having a air brake switch, which is a gang operated switch, which is being used for connecting or disconnecting the supply or making or breaking the supply. Then you will be having an 11 kV lightning arrester. And from there it is given to a outdoor cable box of 11 kV rating. Why? Because whatever the line which is being taken from the distribution line, now the power has to be transmitted through an underground cable. So here you are having an 11 kV underground cable. So this is an outdoor cable box which is to be kept outside. And from there, from the outdoor cable box, then you need to have a provision for metering. So that is, a metering CT is also required, and similarly a PT is also required. So that is a potential transformer and a current transformer is required. So a metering CT is being shown over here, and then for potential transformer, what you are trying to do is that this 11 kV supply you are stepping down to 110 volt using a transformer, and then it is given to a metering equipment. Then the system also houses the protection CT in order to protect it in case of any kind of faults. From there it is given to an 11 kV oil circuit breaker. And from the circuit breaker, it is given to the transformer. So from this part onwards, whatever you see here is nothing but housed inside the substation. So you will be having an 11 kV by 433 volt transformer. Secondary is star connected, and therefore you are using a 3.5 core LT cable. From there, it goes to the LT circuit breaker. So depending upon the capacity of your transformer and also the loads which is connected, you may be using different kind of circuit breakers. For higher ratings, you will be using an oil circuit breaker, and you will also have a protection CT again in order to trip the circuit, trip this circuit breaker in case of any kind of faults. From there, it is going to an LT bus bar. So what you see over here is nothing but an LT bus bar. So it is a long shaped conductor. It can be a rectangle in shape. From there, you are taking your supply to your sub circuits. So you will be having circuit breakers or switch fuse units depending upon the capacity of the loads to which it is being connected. So from there you are getting the outgoing LT lines. So this is how a single line diagram of a particular indoor substation is looking like. So this is the layout of a particular indoor substation. So this is nothing but the sides of your building. You have your entry door, two doors are there. Then you are receiving a supply from HT line. You will be receiving the supply through you will be having a pole, that is an electric post will be there. From there you will be changing it to a cable. So you will be having an HT cable box will be there. Then you will be having an HT oil circuit breaker, and you will also have your metering equipments. So the metering equipments will be measuring, it will be a time of day tariff meter. So it will be measuring the energy consumption during various times of the day during during the off-peak hours, peak hours, and the normal hours. It will also measure the maximum demand because we have to pay for electricity bill, not only for the energy consumed, but also for the maximum demand charges will be there. So after that, you will be having the circuit breaker. Then it comes to the transformer. So this what you see over here is nothing but a transformer here. And from this transformer, you will be having the secondary of the transformer, that is the bushings will be there. From there, a 3.5 core cable will be running to the LT bus bar chamber. So this is nothing but a bus bar chamber. And here you will be having an incoming circuit breaker. So if this circuit breaker is being tripped, then it will not provide any power to any of the loads which is connected to this LT bus bar. So the entire power from the incoming circuit breaker is being given to these numbers 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5, 6, just indicating that 1, 2, 3 is using an oil circuit breaker for outgoing distributors and 4, 5, 6 is for the switch. So that will vary depending upon the type of the load which is being connected. Then you will be having a shock treatment charge. So during a period of shock or electrocution, what has to be the first aid to be provided, which is mandatory as per the standards. Then you will be having your first aid box. So the intention of the first aid box is when it is electrocuted, then you need to provide the first aid to the person. So the stuff which is required for doing a first aid is given in the first aid box. Then you will be having a fire extinguisher. It is basically in order to provide, in order to extinguish the fire in case it happens in the system. And so you can see that a sufficient room has to be kept inside the substation for ample operability inside the system. So that is the layout of an indoor substation. So another requirement is the earthing requirement. So your neutral has to be earth. The body of the transformer, the body of your panel boards, everything has to be earth. So for that purpose, for a single transformer, they will be having two separate and distinct earth electrodes has to be provided for the neutral earthing. That is, the neutral earthing, you need to have a two separate and distinct earth electrodes. And for earthing the body of the transformer, then your panel boards, that is the high voltage panel and also the low voltage panel, the earth conductor is to be connected to a common earth bus, which is run between two separate and distinct earth electrodes. So that's for a single transformer, you will be having four electrodes will be there, earth electrodes will be there. And similarly, in the case of a two transformer which is inside a substation, then the total number of earth electrodes will be six. That is, you will be adding another two earth electrodes for earthing the neutral of the second transformer. And the body and the panels will be used to the previous earthing terminal itself. So that is the case with the indoor substation. Okay, thank you.